Alright, so this will probably be a quick update. I didn't beat as many games as I did previous times. So before, I beat 5 games in the last month. Well, the last video, I beat 5 games. The video before that, also 5 games. So this time, I beat 1 game, but that's okay for reasons. Because here's the thing. I'm currently playing through the longest game on my list. So I wasn't planning on beating a bunch of games. Actually, I wasn't even planning on playing the game that I'm playing. Well, here's the game I beat. Let's start off. It's pretty freestyle now. Like, I'm just kind of doing whatever, saying whatever. You know, we're just chilling out in my bed. It's fine. It's normal. I beat this game. The Witcher 2, Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition. I didn't play this version. I played the PC version. This is the Xbox version. Xbox. Because, you can import your save from the first Witcher game. And, it does almost nothing, but the almost part is the part that matters. So, funnily enough, The Witcher 2 on PC, on my PC, ran better than The Witcher 1 did. And better than The Witcher 3 does on PS4. I had zero issues with Witcher 2. No crashes, no nothing. The Witcher 3, on the other hand, which is what I'm currently playing through, this guy, the complete edition, right there. This doesn't run great on PS4. It's I think 2 years old now, something like that. So, like, you would think they'd get it all ironed out, all the kinks ironed out. I don't know if, like, the last patch added some problems or whatnot, because I've had a crash to, I was going to say desktop, I was crashed to the home screen on the PS4. I am playing on an original PS4, so there's no, there's no pro stuff there. So that's kind of weird, but I've gotten used to it. I've only had the one crash. There's some weird audio glitch things, but you know, whatevs. It's a fantastic game. But let's get into The Witcher 2, because that's the only game I beat. So The Witcher 1 took me. That's this guy right here. I've got him too. Right there. The Witcher 1 took me like 5 years to beat. I bought it a while ago and then played through the beginning several times before I finally got into it. And I'm glad I beat it finally. And it's not a bad game. It's a good game. It's a great game. It's just slow and old. Kind of like, I was going to say old people, but I said old and then old people. It's not a great joke, you know. We're just freestyling here. We're just hanging out. Don't worry about it. There's no script. Probably should have one next time. But anyway, so beat The Witcher 1. And that was towards the end of the month that I was in. So I think there was like 2 or 3 days, where I didn't really play anything. And then I made my video. And then, I can't remember if I actually started Witcher 2, but it doesn't matter, during the video. But anyway, whatever. So I played Witcher 2. This game took me 4 days to beat. I beat it in 4 sittings. And one sitting was half the game. So it was a good game. Great, great game. Not perfect. None of these games are, not all 3 of them aren't perfect, but they all, I don't know, they all have something about them. And it's weird, because, like, they're all great in different ways, and they're all flawed in different ways. It's three games, and they're all vastly different from each other. The Witcher 2, like I said, like it ran fantastically. It's a bit difficult to play for me. I played on normal. I play every game on normal because I figure normal is how the game's supposed to be played, and then you can, you know, do whatever. But anyway, so I played on normal, and the thing that makes it more difficult is that there's like you can't drink potions during a battle. You can in the first game. You can in the third game. Potions, they like enhance stuff. There's a million different ones, and they all give you like buffs. But then The Witcher 2, you have to do it before you get into battle. You can only do it when you're meditating, and you can only meditate in like safe areas. So that's kind of weird. So you have to basically predict what potions you'll need, and then drink them, or not drink them, and then, you know, get murdered, and then be like, okay, so I need this for this fight. So, but still, like, story was great. It was a lot different than the first one. It's shorter than the first one. And the thing that made it weird for me was the first Witcher game has five chapters, you know, plus a prologue and an epilogue and whatever. And I don't know why, but I assumed Witcher 2 had five. And so when the ending came in chapter 3, I was like, oh, we're here. We're at the end already. I was still thinking about, like, okay, where am I going to put my points in my character so I can, you know, enhance his abilities. I was still thinking ahead, and I'm like, oh, I'm at the end. So so that kind of came quickly out of nowhere. But it was good. It was still good. Yeah, good game, good series. And then I started playing 3 immediately afterwards. That's a lie. Almost immediately. Basically, once I beat it, I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to go out and buy this. Because I didn't own The Witcher 3 when I started Witcher 2. And I wasn't going to jump right in because I never jump right in because... Yeah, I don't want to get burned out, but man, I was into it, so that's what I did. I went out, I bought Witcher 3, and I've been playing it ever since. I've been playing it for a while. It's a very long game. There's a lot in it, and it's fun. It's just fun. It's a fun game. It's also not perfect, but it's still really good. Yeah, well, so I did switch up the list a bit. I'm not sure if I can completely remember all the changes I made. I keep it all on my trusty dusty phone, my list. So what did I change? Oh, let's see. What did I take off? I know what I added because it's in my right here in my face. What did I take off? I took off Xenoblade Chronicles. Because that was the longest game on my list, and I decided if I'm going to play The Witcher 3, which is a long game, that would be the game to replace it with. So that's got pushed out. So Witcher 3 is on there now. And, can't remember. Oh, Pac-Man 2? No. I played Pac-Man 2. I took that off the list already, but I went ahead and played it. But I didn't beat it, which is why I thought I took it off the list, because I didn't beat it, but I didn't. I took it off the list because I replaced it, and it was too short of a game, but I ended up not beating it anyway. So, there it is. What else did I take off the list? I took something off. I took a few things off, because I added that, too. I don't know. I'll have it out. I took some other stuff off the list. And I added a game that's not out yet. Comes out March. It's Detective Pikachu for the 3DS. It looks... I don't know why, but when I watch the trailer, I just have a dumb smile on my face the whole time. Like, I've fallen for the gimmick of a talking Pikachu. A gruff talking Pikachu. It's working on me. So I'm getting that game and I'm gonna play it. And hopefully it's, good because I'm buying it. So I can't remember. So I'm kind of like I kind of forgot about making this video. So like I already got myself like in the mindset that I have nothing else to do for the day, and I was playing some Sega Genesis, was playing was in the mood for some old stuff, and there's a reason for that. Because tomorrow is March 1st, and the reason why that's significant is because the place I go to get video games, old video games, it's called The Exchange. It's they have like music. It used to be called the Record Exchange, because records. But then they were like, oh, records aren't really a thing anymore. So then they dropped the record part, but now records are a thing again. So like they should bring it back. But anyway, they sell old used fun things. So, but the reason why I'm excited for tomorrow, March 1st, is because they have a card. By the way, this video is not endorsed by the Exchange. I totally would sell out to them because I like them. Actually applied to work there. Still waiting on that call. But anyway, they have a card where you get 20% off used purchases, once a year for your birthday. During your birthday month, you get for one transaction, you get 20% off. The card eventually is supposed to do more. Because that's not a lot, you get a discount once a year for having the card. Seems kind of pointless. But anyway, I've decided for my birthday, I'm giving myself a small budget, and I'm gonna go buy a pile of old video games. So I'm excited to do that. So I've been in an old video game mood, playing some Sega stuff. I'll probably buy 100% Sega games. I've got a list. Let's see. I've got a list of games I want. I don't know if you can see. I don't know if I've done this already. I think I've already done this. This seems familiar. I did this, and then you couldn't see it, and I was like, nah, whatever. But anyway, anyway. This is going to work. See, all that is categories. So, and then hit a category and boom, there's a list of DS games I want right there, and then that scrolls, of course, and there are all kinds of stuff. Basically, I think I've already been over that list. I like lists. I don't know, it's a thing, but anyway, I think I've already been over that, so I'm not gonna go over it again. There's not that there's anything to go over. It's a list of games I want. What's to go over? Anyway. So I'm buying a pile of old games tomorrow, and excited. This is my excited face. So yeah, I have played some other stuff. I kind of took it easy on the list this month, not necessarily taking a break from it. But I knew I was playing a really long game, so I wasn't going to worry about the number of games that I beat. So I was playing some older stuff. I was playing some Mickey Mania on the Sega CD. That game's not very good. I think I already went over that. I got to like the last level, but it's hard in the wrong way. Like it's not well designed. At all. Great music. Graphics are cool. But the gameplay part, not so great. Doesn't control great. Level design's not great. It's like, oh, I died because I didn't already know you're supposed to do this. But still, like, I'd like to beat it because, like, I get right to the end and then I don't quite make it. And it's a short game, so it's not a big deal. And just playing some other stuff. There was There was something else, I think. Oh. So I've just been kind of doing that. Oh, I read a book. So that's another reason why I don't have many games on this list this time. Because I read a book. I read the first Witcher book, which I actually already read a while ago. Back when I decided to read all the Witcher books before playing the first Witcher game, and then I decided not to do that. I don't think I made a conscious decision not to do it. I just never bought all the books. But I bought all the books, so now I'm going to read them all. And so I reread the first one, which is this, The Last Wish series of short stories. And the second book, which I just started, is The Sword of Destiny, also a series of short stories. And then after that, there's five books that's like one continuous story, a la Lord of the Rings. And then there's like a new one that just came out that takes place before everything, I think. Which is kind of interesting because these books were all written in the 90s. So the fact that a new one just came out is kind of interesting. But I probably won't get that for a while. Because I don't like to buy books in hardcover because they cost more. I actually like the little paperbacks, but the five of the seven Witcher books aren't in the small paperback. The only ones that are in the small paperback is book one and three, which is really annoying. But they also have the other books in the tall paperback, so I just bought them all that way. And in my old age, with the eye thing, I don't have an eye thing. It's just saying the eyes in general, as you reach your elder years, they're not as good. So I'm appreciating the bigger books with the bigger text. Not that it's huge text. I mean, it's still, I opened the book, I expected bigger words, but it's still pretty darn small. I mean, I guess it's standard. But yeah, good stuff. It ain't no Game of Thrones. Not that I've ever watched or read anything Game of Thrones, but I hear people saying it's not Game of Thrones, so it must not be. Which is obvious because it says The Witcher on it, so it wouldn't be Game of Thrones. But it's they're the Witcher books are kind of like they feel like R-rated teen novels, if that makes sense. Like it feels like it's at a teen reading level, but there's swear words and naughty bits in it. But still, it's really good. Like I'm not saying that as a bad thing. They're easy to read, and that's appreciated. Yeah, they're good. They're pretty good. They're pretty good. So, yeah. I don't know, like I said, this one's short, relatively speaking, compared to the other ones. Because I don't have anything else to say, really, other than play The Witcher, read The Witcher, all things Witcher, witchy, witch, witcher, witch, witchity, witch, which witch is witching, witch, witchers, witcher. The cool thing about The Witcher. There's a lot of cool things about The Witcher, but there's one thing I don't remember. Like reading just reading the first book has already like helped out with a lot of stuff regarding the lore and everything. Because the games, they don't spell everything out for you. Like the name Witcher, I don't think is ever mentioned. Well, it's mentioned. I don't think the meaning of it is mentioned, or like where the name came from. It's basically. Witcher is like a male witch. It was a derogatory term that they took over and made their own. So it's like, oh, because like witchers can use a little bit of magic but not a lot. So it's like that's kind of like witches where they're more like toil and trouble and stirring the cauldron and whatever. But so you're like, oh, you're like a male witch. Like, not really, but we'll take it. Whatever. Whatevs, fam. That was old Geralt there. That was my Geralt impression. Yeah, whatevs, fam. So, that's how he talks. That's how he wants to talk, but he doesn't talk that way. So, we got the Witchers right there. I need to do a... We'll just do it now so I don't have to do it later. We'll do like a thing. We'll do a thing here where I show them all. And I'll make the thumbnail with my name and face. Except not my face because it's in front of there. So there we go. This is the thumbnail or something. There, it's a good thumbnail. Put my name back there. Bretsky128. You know, because, you know. It's a brand. It's a brand now. Branding, it's important. So, all right. I wish I had more to talk about because I don't have a lot to talk about. I didn't play a whole lot, but next time there'll be more. Probably, if not, you know, whatever. Maybe I'll make a video going over the games I buy. I don't know. I mean, some people like that. If it's, you know, I've watched haul videos before, so not a lot, but there are certain people I like that I watch. So yeah, I'll do a haul video. There we go. Do one of those to make up for the not playing much, you know. And if you don't like or care about video games at all, then you can just you can just watch other videos that I make. Which, I mean, if you don't like video games, there's probably not a lot to. Not a lot to offer. The occasional meme video, which the one I made, which combined two different memes into one, closed in on 2,000 views. So that's weird because that took me like 20 minutes to make. So, and then these videos that I'm doing here get like 9. So but that's okay because I'm just sitting here and like. Like I said, they're just kind of, you know, whatever. They're whatever vids. So, alright. I know I said I was done a while ago, but I'm still just kind of rambling on. But, I think this time it's it. It's it, fam. There's a glare on my glasses. You can't see my eyes. Turn that. Oh, look at that. Let there be no light. Ooh, setting the mood. Here we go. Nope, we're good. Gonna be done. Gonna hit the stop recording button in 3,